The option to now add your own custom dashboard to your component has actually finally come. I might have mentioned this in some previous tutorials, but it's somewhat hidden, and so I thought, well, let's do a quick tutorial just about this. So in the past, all components, basically its layout, ended up as a dashboard looking like this, obviously with your own icons, but you could do only about what you see here. And this is still the default dashboard. So if you don't add your own, it'll basically build this for you based on your fields, based on its icons and layout selection. So you could add tabs like we have here, and these tabs are quite powerful. You can really add a lot of functionality within that. But for some of you, this might be boring and not really what you would like. In fact, you want to look different. You don't want your component to look like it was built with JCB. And I don't blame you, because that is what makes components valuable, is that they are actually unique. And that is really why JCB exists. It exists because I didn't want a cookie cutter component. I wanted to build my own components that actually look different from each other and yet have similar behavior because of my company's approach. But none of the other out there actually could do that for me. We ended up looking just like, you know, the one we were using. So now with JCB, we're constantly trying to make sure that this is not the case. In fact, that's why the side view area is a little bit more difficult, because we want to give you the opportunity to express your component's functionality in a way that's unique to you. This might be a challenge, but in the long run, believe me, it is the advantage. If you could do it without knowing any JavaScript or CSS or HTML, then anyone else can do it as well. So there is like a little bit of a incentive to sort of get your head around some of these technologies. In any case, to be a good component developer and not knowing PHP and those front-end languages is most certainly a risk. Okay, well, so without further ado, if we were to go, we'll have here this common known Hello World component. And if we were to open it in the website now, this is its dashboard. Now, it doesn't have a custom dashboard, and I'm not going to add one at this point, but I am going to take away the dashboard it has, and so that it sort of behaves like the article manager, for example. If we would go here, there's in the components area, there is a new tab, or rather a tab called dash and install. And you see here it has the default, and then here it has some description of what that means. If you click on dynamic, it actually gives you a list of all the available sites or views that are linked to the component. And that would be custom admin views as well as normal admin views. It will show you a list of them all. And you can then select any of those, and that will become the new dashboard for your component. So basically save and close, and go to the compiler and compile the Hello World component, and basically just reinstall. So to demonstrate how that changed our component's behavior, so click on install. Then we'll basically go to components and click on this Hello World link to see what it does now as its default dashboard. And so it loads the list view and the dashboard is gone. So from this point forward, your Hello World component actually looks like this, and it doesn't have a dashboard. Now, you could use a custom dashboard, which in our case, if you're using a component that has custom admin views, so JCB has the compiler and the get snippets area as custom admin views. So if we were to do the similar thing with JCB, we could just as well select one of those, obviously say dynamic, and select one of those views. So scroll down a bit, where is it? There, the compiler. We could make the compiler JCB's dashboard. Now, I know it's gonna break a lot of things somehow, I suppose, but let's try it out. So we've got JCB now, we switched it to have another dashboard instead of the normal dashboard. I'm gonna compile it here and then install. Before I install it, I just want to tell you what I meant by things might break. If we've got a bunch of tabs here, and all of these tabs are getting information and making it available to you so you could just get enough information from us. And we've got the version here and the last build date, and so you are basically gonna remove this whole area. So, or we just did. So if I click on this install, we see first it tells us that this language string is no longer here. And at first it seems like it's a broken issue, but if we refreshed it, you'll see that it'll actually remove it. And so it's just a cache thing there. So basically the dashboard's gone. And if I was to go here and click on component builder, it'll from now on open right at the compiler. And that will now be its default page, which is what we told it. And so the behavior is correct. We don't see any issues. And actually, if you were to gonna go to the code, the dashboard is completely removed, all its files, everything, and so none trace of it is left. Obviously, to undo this, you could simply say default again and save and close, and then compile it again, and it will place the dashboard back. So that's not really any harm done to the component, but for those of you who want to take the custom admin views and design a much more impressive, maybe not a boring dashboard, can now do so by simply using this new feature. And I'm sure it's going to be a lot of fun. So there, if we refresh now, our dashboard is back, and if we click on it, there we go, everything is fine again. Phew. Anyway, thanks for watching.